Hi my loves, it's been a little while since I vlogged, but I thought I would start a vlog today because Zach and I are going to go down to New Orleans. Last week we were in St. Lucia, we did a lot of chilling out, relaxing, sunbathing. If you guys want to see some more of that, there is an Insta story highlight, so you guys can go and see St. Lucia. Then we came over, landed in Atlanta, drove to Chattanooga for a night, and then drove to Memphis day before yesterday. I've just been catching up with my dad and all sorts. So yeah, it's been nice. Had a long walk around Memphis and stuff. But yeah, we're gonna head down to New Orleans today. Obviously everyone's at work and school and stuff, so we thought we would go and do something in the week. So that's what we're doing. And I'm really excited. I need to put some makeup on, I've got my outfit on. But yeah, if you guys don't know, obviously, my dad lives in Memphis now. Oh, there she is. Hi, Bella. Hi, Bella. Hi, Gorge. Come on, then. Come on. Come and see me. Oh, he's so gorgeous. Oh, she's so soft. What's that, she said? What's that? Oh, she's so soft. But neither did we want to stop and delay getting to New Orleans. So we are getting a McD's. Dangerous. Let me be the one who calls you dangerous. So we've arrived. We do have two big windows, but one of our blinds is broken currently. We didn't do it. Zach's having a rest because it's been a long drive. Big, big bed. This is our shower. Polo's in here. And this is our like sink setup. A nice little table. So that's us. And we're in the Catahoula Hotel. So I've changed, as you can see. And we are heading to dinner. We're gonna go to Pesh. What kind of food is it, Zach?
Seafood.
Seafood. Seafood. And it's starting to look a bit more classically New Orleans. In this area that we are now, because I think the hotel's in the business district. Games you like to play, controlling me too. So guys, I am just hopping in here from the future because I did a pretty bad job at narrating what we were doing, but I did a lot of filming of what we were eating, but not a lot of narrating. We had dinner at Pesh, as you saw, which was really, really nice. It was probably one of my favorite meals that we had just because it was quite chill compared to some of the like more high-end places, and the food was really good. I can't remember what it was that was particularly nice. It was the shrimp the like shrimp with rice. I think it was just called like grilled shrimp with rice or something, and it was really, really, really nice. So we enjoyed Pesh, and then we were pretty tired, so we went back to bed. And then the next morning, we got up. We had to switch rooms that day, so we had to move out of one room and into another, and unfortunately, it wasn't very well coordinated, and it was really sunny that day as well. So we missed a little bit of the sunshine, trying to like organize our room situation. But we got out of our first room, went to Café Beignet for a coffee. I wanted to wait for beignets at Café du Monde, but I'm actually a bit upset that I didn't get beignets at Café Beignet as well. We are at Café Beignet. We're not actually having any beignets. I think we'll have those later because we've got lunch at Galatoire's, so we're just having a coffee. We were going then to dinner at Galatoire's, which was super beautiful. We had gumbo, we had shrimp etouffee. In fact, I think it was crawfish etouffee. We had like various different like classic Cajun dishes there. Probably wasn't like my favourite meal that we had, although the inside of Galatoire's is gorgeous. And then, yeah, we headed back to the room. This is only sad for me, really, because you guys probably don't care, but this was the sunniest day and we didn't take any pictures outside. So now I'm kind of beating myself up about that, but that's okay, because I want to go back to New Orleans one day. Maybe on my next visit and when I know it's going to be like a little bit better weather. Yeah, we went back, sorted out our room, and then went out that evening for some drinks at Bacchanal in Bywater, I think the area is called. Now we're going to go out to Bacchanal, which lots of you guys recommended on Instagram, which is like a wine and cheese place, just for a drink, I think, but on the Mississippi River. So we've just arrived at Bacchanal. It's a little bit further from our hotel than the French Quarter is. And we got some rosé chilling. I need some water because all I've drunk today is a champagne cocktail and a coffee. So we're hydrating at the same time. So we are in the joint and I completely forgot to film my food. But it's really good actually. We're really near Bacchanal. So we had some drinks at Bacchanal, which was lovely. And then a couple hours in, they have like a really nice big outside space. And I know that probably most nights they have like jazz and stuff there as well. We didn't stay late enough for that. We were supposed to go back after our food, but we were pretty tired again. I don't know what it was. I don't know if it was just like leftover jet lag or something, but yeah, we were pretty sleepy after our food. But yeah, we had some wine and then it started raining, but we made it to the joint afterwards and it was really, really nice in there. Another one of like my favorite places we went to eat because it was just like good, hearty American food. So we enjoyed the joint. Next day the weather was looking pretty sketchy, so we thought we would do a drive instead of like walking around town. Good morning, you guys. Today Zach and I are going to do a little bit of a drive around through the bayou and just like the surrounding area of New Orleans. Yeah, I kind of wanted to do a swamp tour, but then I googled it and apparently a lot of them are not very good for the environment or animals. So we're going to just have a little explore by ourselves today. It's a little bit more overcast than it was yesterday. I don't know if it's going to get sunnier later on. I hope so. Maybe drive through little bits of the city this morning and then we're going to go to Vietnamese for lunch because we didn't go last night. Because lots of the restaurants, Vietnamese restaurants, like close at 7, 8, whatever. We'll be go for lunch today and then we've got a nice dinner tonight at Brennan's. So yeah, I'm excited, and also I want to get some beignets today. It's beignets day. We're on our way out of the city again. Watch that, you guys. We're stopping for coffee at PJ's.
Got some strawberries.
I wanted to look at some of the bayou and stuff. Unfortunately, I think some of the best roads, like country roads for the bayou, were a bit further away even. So I think next time we go to Louisiana, we'll just do a bit more. So we did a little bit of bayou on Highway 307, I think it was. And it was just nice driving on like country roads as opposed to the interstate for a bit. And we also visited, we also passed a lot of the plantations. I was conflicted about whether I wanted to go in one, but seeing as we'd gone all the way out there and we'd been driving for a few hours, we thought we would stop at Huma's house In hindsight, I don't think that was the best one for us to stop at. I think I would have preferred to go to one of the other plantations. But yeah, I was conflicted because it's a hard one really, isn't it? Like, it's a piece of history, but lots, obviously the history of those plantations is incredibly sad, and the history of slavery at them. Certainly some of them don't emphasise slavery or slavery tours. I think a couple of them do, so I think I would have preferred to have gone. I think it's the Whitney Plantation, or the Laura Plantation maybe. I'm not entirely sure. But yeah, I think we went to the wrong one really. So, and the feeling walking around the plantation, a lot of them are very, very beautiful, but it gave me a really, really sad feeling. Anyway, so we did stop briefly in Hume's house, as you can see. We didn't go in the house or anything, we just kind of wandered around the gardens. And then we went back into the city. We had a really lovely Vietnamese meal at Phở Tàu Bay, I think it was called. That was really, really nice as well. If you guys don't know, New Orleans has a really big Vietnamese community, so hence why there's a few Vietnamese restaurants there and we wanted to go to one. Okay, so we are back from our drive, you guys. And we are in Phở Tàu Bay and we are excited to eat because we haven't eaten anything today.
Oh my god, I'm so excited!
So, food was delicious, very nice, and nice to have like fresh tasting food because it's been a lot of non-fresh tasting food, a lot of fried food. But we are gonna drive around the garden district now, I think, and maybe have a little walk in the city park. We are observing mansions. Unfortunately, as you can see, it's pouring it down with rain and everyone's kind of lost their minds in terms of their driving ability. But they are gorgeous. Hanging with new names and I know that ain't you. And it's alright, we all got our phases, babe. I wanna put myself in danger, babe. Currently on Magazine Street, which is known for its shopping and stuff. So we have driven around lots of New Orleans today. And this is Jackson Park, I think. Or am I right? I'm not sure. And we've seen lots of things. But we're going to go to Cafe Du Monde now and get some beignets, which I'm excited about, by we're on the Mississippi again. Here it is. Now we've come back after our beignets and quickly changed, and we're gonna go have a drink at the hotel bar. This is my outfit for this evening. It's a little bit revealing, but it's a really nice top. This, the only problem with it is I haven't got a pair of trousers here with me that kind of sit lower down or don't have like a button, so we're just going with the jeans. But that's my outfit. Apologies for the mess. The problem with the whole millions of suitcases thing is that as soon as you walk into a room, no matter how neat you are, you immediately make loads and loads of mess. So I've made loads and loads of mess. Anyway, Zach's already gone down to order our drinks, so I'm gonna go down and join him now. Yeah, excited for this evening. We're gonna go out tonight. We were old people last night because we were just super tired for some reason. Just tired all the time at the moment. I don't know if it's leftover jet lag or what it is, but yeah, I'm gonna get rid of this piece. It's annoying me on the side of my head. So yeah, but tonight we're gonna go out. Make it a vibe for me. Oh. Your caramel complexion has got me under your spell. And that evening we went to dinner at Brennan's, which was really nice as well. I had the blackened redfish. It's not blackened in the traditional way at Brennan's, but it was really, really delicious. And the decor in there is gorgeous as well. We weren't in the proper dining room because I managed to mix up our reservation. It was still very beautiful. So I'd recommend Brennan's over Galatoire's if you're looking for like kind of a high-end New Orleans meal. And then after that, we went for some drinks at the Spotted Cat, which was really good fun. general, Frenchman Street seemed like a really great place to be and to go out away from the Bourbon Street touristy area, and had loads of music and bars and stuff, and all of them seemed to be going off. We have just left our room at the Capitol Hotel, and we are on our way for brunch at Willa Jean, which I'm excited about. Zach ordered this appetizer of poutine, and it's absolutely enormous. How pretty does this look? And there was also a lot of things on that list which I feel like we didn't do. Like I said, we didn't do like a proper bayou trip. I don't know whether I would want to do one in a boat. If you guys have recommendations for good tour companies to do like bayou trips with, then let me know, because I know a lot of them are not good for the animals or the environment. We didn't eat po' boys. Ridiculous, I know. We didn't eat any oysters. There are a few other restaurants that I would really like to have gone to. And yeah, I would have really liked to have had a bit more time wandering around on foot when the weather was better. But I want to thank you guys. If any of you replied to my Instagram questions about recommendations to New Orleans, pretty much everything I just said was recommended by you guys, so thank you so much for that. You really improved our trip. But yeah, I think New Orleans has a lot to do and going for it, so yeah, I would have liked to have been there for a bit longer. I think you could even spend like 4 or 5 days there doing lots of different things. We had a really good time and I would definitely love to go back. It just has a really good vibe. That's it, you guys. Then we drove back to Memphis. I will have Memphis vlogs up for you very soon. And next week I'm going to New York as well, so hopefully there should be some New York vlogs too coming your way. It's been a while since I travel vlogged, so as you could probably tell, I was a little bit out of practice on that. There will be more NOLA on the channel in the future, I am sure. Thank you guys so much for watching today, and I will see you again very soon. Bye!